all of the United States. In the summer of 1999, 7 people in the New York City area had died of encephalitis, inflammation of the brain, and at least 55 others were sickened. At the same time, crows and exotic birds at the Bronx Zoo were also dying of an unusual brain infection. A veterinary pathologist working with the National Veterinary Services Laboratory was able to link the two seemingly unrelated occurrences to the same agent, West Nile virus. How the disease was originally introduced in the United States is unclear, but it's believed that migratory birds were the culprits. The disease did not spread directly from person to person or animal to animal. For the spread of the virus to occur, a mosquito bite is typically needed. The mosquito obtains a blood meal from an affected bird and then injects a small amount of the infectious agent into the next animal victim. West Nile virus most commonly affects birds and horses, rarely cats, dogs, pet birds, and people. Less than 1% of people bitten by an infected mosquito become ill. Signs can be mild flu-like symptoms in people, to incoordination, weakness, or death in horses and birds. There's no specific treatment for this viral-induced encephalitis. Supportive care is key while the immune system grapples with this infection. So why am I telling you about a disease that mainly affects horses and birds while you're seated in your veterinarian's office? You can play a critical role in slowing down the spread of this disease. Prevention of mosquito bites is of paramount importance. Eliminating standing water in your yard, keeping your window screens in good repair, dress appropriately, and apply insect repellent to your pets and yourself when you venture outside. Always read label directions before applying insecticides. Products that may be safe for a dog may be highly toxic to a cat. If you own a horse, get it vaccinated. At this time, there's no vaccines available for other species. Have questions about how you can best protect yourself and your pets from this and other shared diseases? Just ask your veterinarian.